The aim of yoga is to make the mind so malleable that it can easily be applied wherever we wish to. Those who have achieved some great feats anywhere in the world and cleanly utilized their life in desired routes and tasks are all yogis, even though they may not be attired in typical yogi garb. Some people apply their mental competence in realizing God, and some others in uncovering physical truths. Thus, the applications may vary from person to person, but they all ultimately do the same. Pandit Shriram Sharma Acharya. Book title: Pratyahar, Dharana, Dhyan or Samadhi. Pratyahara, withdrawal of senses. Dharana, concentration of mind. Dhyana, meditation. And Samadhi, 8th step in Patanjali Yoga, a state where individual and universal consciousness unite, a state of superconsciousness or enlightenment. Book introduction. Rishi's Patanjali Yoga Sutras, the 8th step yoga system, is a well-known treatise on Raja Yoga. The book is the third in the series on Patanjali's Yoga Sutras exposition. The first two books deal with yama or restraining unworthy thoughts, actions and conduct, niyama or cultivating good habits, asana or yogic postures, and pranayama or controlling breathing and prana. These two titles mainly aim at attaining physical and mental fitness in preparation for the next stage of pratyahara, dharana, dhyana and samadhi. The clear and concise exposition of which is presented in this book alongside some simple practices for each. The author starts with a word of caution for yoga enthusiasts not to ignore the initial four steps of yama, niyama, asana and pranayama, as they would provide the indispensable foundation for reaping the great benefits of the other four graded steps of pratyahara, dharana, dhyana and samadhi have to offer. These remaining four steps aim to control the mind, which is the single most determining factor in anyone's life. It is the mind that forms the basis of success or failure, progress or regress, happiness or sadness, etc. Once a person masters the art of controlling the mind, they could employ it to realize any desired aim of life, whether it is spiritual or worldly. This book walks us through the second half of Raja Yoga, intending to tame and train the unruly mind behaving like an unbridled calf or a wild horse into a well-controlled mind, which can be easily and willingly engaged into whichever direction or task we wish and reap the relevant benefits. We get to know all about analyzing the mind, the ways to get rid of the unworthy and replace them with worthy and empowering thoughts and beliefs, embarking upon meditation. What to meditate upon and how to meditate, evolving it further to make the mind becoming completely absorbed into any desired target or object. We get a clear understanding through analogies, stories, real-life examples, as well as some simple practices and affirmations. Remember, everyone can become a yogi whether they are attired in an orange garb or in a smart suit, whether they are spiritual or worldly minded, whether they are after God's realization or seeking physical comforts. Few excerpts from the book. The principles and methods of yama, niyama and asana pranayama are meant for achieving physical and mental fitness. Yoga scriptures give sound advice about the necessity of physical and mental well-being and a disease-free state before taking up any major task. We should achieve external physical success first and then only engage in sadhana, or practices to achieve inner spiritual development. Those who pay no attention to improving their external physical life and think of becoming yogi overnight are actually wasting their time. It will be difficult for them to achieve any notable success. If there is anything of the essence in human being, it is indeed the mind. This is the tool with the help of which any individual carries out small or big tasks and attains merits or demerits, progress or ruin, success or failure, heaven or hell. If people had learnt and been able to utilize this tool in the form of their minds properly, more than half of the miseries of the world would have resolved automatically. The later half of the Raja Yoga Sadhana is described in this book with a specific aim. Everyone can learn the art of having proper control over the mind and utilize it in the way they really want to. The control of the mind is such a blessing that it can turn a beastly person into a good human being and a good person into a living God. This includes the greatest 8 spiritual accomplishments and 9 worldly treasures described in the scriptures. All the miracles we see in the material and spiritual worlds are just the wonders of the control of the mind. Gita states, "The mind is man's greatest friend." A controlled mind is in fact a real blessing that can help achieve anything wished for. Proper utilization of a controlled mind's powers can help a person achieve everything. Raja Yoga is the knowledge of making life what it ideally should be. The later half of the Raja Yoga is all about the ways to bring the mind under control. Yoga and God's realization are two different things. Yoga is the science, knowledge, a tool, and an art of learning to bring the powers of the mind under one's control and to make use of them. It is one's own choice whether to apply that knowledge to realize God or accomplish material tasks. Pratyahara is made of two words, prati and ahar. Ahar means food intake and pratyahara means vomiting up or expel. For example, the act of breathing in represents ahar or intake, and that of breathing out represents pratyahara or expel. Yoga sadhana involves the practices of dharana, dhyana and samadhi. Still, before they are undertaken, it is essential to perform pratyahara because it is impossible to install a new thing without making room for it. Great tasks like yoga practice need some cleanup first, which itself is known as pratyahara. The purpose of pratyahara is to make the mind such that it can become the basis to bring in the great gifts that dharana, dhyana and samadhi offer. The inner voice of pratyahara is yelling to us, throw out all the evil, throw out all the bad thoughts. Track down each and every unnecessary and outdated element from your nature and beliefs and brush them off forever. You should dispose of all inherent evil tendencies, break off all the connections with them, and never ever let them make a comeback in your life, exactly the way you throw the rubbish out and don't let it come back into your house. Gita says, a person becomes the same as what the nature of his faith is. As a matter of fact, a person himself lays the foundation for his happiness or grief, progress or ruin, bondage or liberation on the basis of his faith or beliefs. The person who believes that he or she is Shiva, the God, would become like Shiva, and the one who believes that he or she is Jiva or an ordinary soul would remain so. The person who believes that he is helpless, grief-stricken, poor, unfit, incapable, unfortunate, and infirm will in fact become the same. However, the person who believes that He is the creator of his destiny, the integral part of God, and an omnipotent soul will no doubt become similarly great. The way the type of flower determines its smell, the type of belief would also attract the relevant conditions one way or another. The readers must fully understand the fact that a man is the maker of his own destiny, not a slave to it. They create spiritual or worldly situations with his or her own strength. No other power can make him reap any benefit or suffer ruin. He himself sows a good or bad seed and then laughs or cries at its relevant outcome. The spiritual scriptures completely accept this self-evident truth and instruct the sadhak to sow only the seeds of fruit they wish to have in their life. You should embrace only those inherent tendencies which can fulfill your wishes. This is the aim of dharana, meaning to contemplate and embrace the desirable. Some affirmations for practicing dharana. I am the hub of perfect health and strength. I am power and the cluster of brilliance. I am the master of my destiny. I am brimming with piety and excellence. I have a well-equipped body, mind, and inner being. A potter kneads the clay thoroughly, and once it becomes adequately malleable, he starts to shape it into various earthenware. The act of controlling the mind is more or less similar. Once the mind becomes malleable through the practices of pratyahara and dharana, it would become easier to make it engage in dhyana or meditation and samadhi or the state of superconsciousness. Dhyana or meditation is the seventh step of Raja Yoga. Meditation stands for engaging in a decided subject with maximum single-minded attention and becoming absorbed into it, so much so that we would forget about everything else. The sunlight passing through a convex lens and converging onto a single point would produce fire. However, the scattered light does not have that much heat to do the same. In the same way, mental powers which remain scattered cannot achieve much, but if they are converged on a single point, they will become advantageous, just like the sunlight passing through the convex lens producing fire. A less competent but more watchful person can achieve more than someone who is more competent but careless. The task carried out with single-minded attention not only succeeds but also enhances the competence of the person. Considering all these facts, various types of meditations have been established in spiritual teaching. Samadhi is the latter half of dhyana or meditation. The same way, dharana is the later half of pratyahara. Samadhi is a state of total meditation. Samadhi is the state when the mind becomes absolutely focused and absorbed into its target and nothing else whatsoever. Raj Yoga is there for everyone. It has been invented to let every person, whether young or old, a householder or a monk. It comprises all those things that also happens in our daily life. It doesn't talk anything about magic or miracles. The one who practices Raja Yoga, Samadhi does not become unconscious, die, become mad, fly in the sky, or display magic of any sort. His or her life will carry on in a natural way as usual. Still, it will make such good spiritual progress that his or her spiritual stability will be fantastic and extraordinary, and he or she will look like a living god on earth. Raja Yoga aims to make you become spiritually oriented and not a juggler. In Samadhi, you will become super conscious and not unconscious. You will not lose your consciousness but will become even more widely awakened. I am the imperishable soul. The body is my attire only. I am spotless. Mind is my tool only. I'm one and the only one. The seeming diversities are just a gimmick. I'm unattached. Virtues, actions, and nature are my wealth only. I'm great. Feeling trivial is nothing but my ignorance. I am truth, consciousness, and bliss. I am self. Only I am there and nothing else. Few topics covered in the book. Patanjali Raja Yoga and its 8 limbs. The mind and its potential. The great importance of having a controlled mind. Pratyahara, Dharana, Dhyana and Samadhi. Concepts and practices.